Hello friends, so in the previous video we have discussed about the basic principle of the lock in amplifier. So in this video we will be discussing about the time constant in lock in amplifier. So this is the front side of the lock in amplifier SR830. So it has a panel called time constant and there are a few buttons to change the value of it. So the question is, what is the meaning of the time constant in lock in amplifier? Why it is important and how will one choose it for an experiment? So before going into that, we'll just go back and discuss like how the locking measure the signals. So in the locking amplifier there will be one input signal and one reference signal. The locking amplifier will multiply these two and will get a signal like this, which has one low frequency component and one high frequency component. So in the case where when the reference frequency and the signal frequency are same, so in that case the mixed signal will be like this, which has one DC component and one AC component. The AC component frequency will be twice of the reference or the signal frequency. So this mixed signal will pass through a series of low pass filter and finally will get the signal, the input signal. So the question about the situation here, this is possible only for ideal case, but in practical there will be noises along with the signal, and because of the finite bandwidth of the low pass filter along with the input signal there will be some noises. So this is the gain versus angular frequency or frequency of the low pass filter. So here this is the bandwidth in this figure. So beyond this the amplitude of different frequency will be very less. So from here to here till bandwidth the gain is almost constant, and the gain is defined when the bandwidth of the low pass filter is defined when the gain become -3 dB. So beyond this point the gain changes with some slope or rapidly. So what is time constant? So the bandwidth of the low pass filter and the time constant in the lock-in amplifier are related by this relation, delta F equal to 1 by 2 pi tau, where tau is the time constant in the lock-in amplifier. So it is clear like when tau increases the delta F decreases and vice versa. So there is one in the time constant panel, there is one thing called slope per octave. So this suggests how fast this will change, the gain will change. Okay, so there are different values, 6 dB, 12 dB, or 24 dB, 18 dB, differently. So one can choose according to the situation. So next question is, why the time constant is important? So in order to understand this, let's assume one example. Let's consider we have two signals, one is our original input signals and one noise. So our input signal is at 500 Hz and the noise is at 600 Hz. So now we have to measure our signal from this noise. We have to separate these two. So let's consider the frequency of the reference signal is 500 Hz, which is same as our signal frequency. So when the lock-in will multiply this reference and the signal, we will get two components, one high frequency component and one low frequency component and one high frequency component. So this will have two set of signals for signal and also noise. So we'll have the signal low frequency component or DC component at 0 Hz and one at high frequency component at 1 kHz. And for noise, the low frequency component will be at 100 Hz and the high frequency component will be at 1100 Hz. So now we have to select our original signal from the noise. So if we use a low pass filter of bandwidth, let's say 200 Hz, in that case what will happen? It will reject the high frequency component of the signal as well as the noise, which are at 1 kHz and 1100 Hz. So we'll have two components, one at one DC component at 0 Hz and one AC component at 100 Hz. So the corresponding time constant, reduce the bandwidth 200 Hz, it will be 795 microseconds, almost 800 microseconds. So now, next, but still we are not able to separate the noise from the signal. So now if we choose bandwidth between 0 to 100, let's say 50 Hz, in that case the time constant will be 3.2 milliseconds, but we will be able to separate the noise component and we will get only the signal. So this is how, by choosing a proper bandwidth, we can reject the noise from our original signal. So now next question is, how will we choose it? So in order to understand this thing, we have taken three different situations scenario where let's say after multiplication with the reference frequency, we will have the signal frequency for the low frequency side at 0 Hz or DC component, and we have noise at three different frequencies. So we have first one 0.5 Hz, the second one at 5 Hz, and the third one at 100 Hz. Now if we want to reject the noise, we can choose some frequency in between these things, the black one and red one. So if we choose the bandwidth of the low pass filter such that delta f equal to 0.1 Hz, in that case we will be able to reject the noises, but the corresponding time constant will be 1.6 seconds. Another thing is there, like the low pass filter require almost 5 times of the time constant to settle its final value, otherwise the value will fluctuate and will not get the reliable value. So we have to wait at least 5 tau time in order to get a stable value. So in this case the data accumulation time will be 1.6 multiplied by 5, that means at least 8 seconds. So we have to wait 8 seconds in order to collect one data and then proceed further. So in this procedure, if we choose this bandwidth, what will happen? The experiment will take long time. So in some cases it is not required. So how will avoid this situation? What we can do, like for this one, we have to choose some bandwidth between 0 to 0.5. We have to choose 0.1, let's say, and data accumulation time will be 8 seconds. But in this case, second one and third one, so we can choose some bandwidth between 0 to 5 Hz. Let's say we choose delta f equal to 1 Hz. So tau will be 160 milliseconds and the data accumulation time will be 800 milliseconds. So in this case the data accumulation time reduces, so we can acquire the data very fast compared to the first case. And also in this case we can do like delta f equal to 10 Hz and the corresponding tau will be 16 milliseconds and the data accumulation time will be 80 milliseconds. Still we can reject the noise without any problem. So in three different cases we can choose the time constant wisely and we can reduce the data accumulation time and the time for our experiment. So we should have some prior knowledge about the noise in our system while doing the experiment, and we can choose the time constant in the lock-in accordingly so that we can avoid the this kind of delay. Okay, so friends, if you like our video, so share it, like it and subscribe.